You are listening to the sixth year of the Montage Film Reviews Sunday DVD Rental Suggestion Podcast. During 2 months dedicated to the actor, producer and environmentalist Leonardo DiCaprio. This documentary film, Struggle, The Life and Lost Art of Szukalski, will be released in 2018 on Netflix. It is set to be directed by Irek Dobrowolski and stars Stanislav Szukalski himself via many hours of video footage that was filmed during his later life. Leonardo DiCaprio and his father George DiCaprio are to produce the film. George DiCaprio is an American writer, editor, publisher, and distributor of underground and independent comics. He was most active during the 1970s and the 1980s. He was known for such titles as Greaser Comics, Forbidden Knowledge, and Cocaine Comics, and has collaborated with Timothy Leary and Laurie Anderson. The documentary tells the story of the Polish artist Stanislav Szukalski and his troubled life, along with his complicated body of work. This is a bonus edition. Glenn Bray, who was a member of the underground comic community in Los Angeles, befriended Polish artist Stanislav Szukalski and introduced him to many of his friends, including Leonardo DiCaprio's father George. This began a lifelong friendship, which ultimately led to the making of this documentary after the artist's death. Born in Warsaw, Poland in 1893, he arrived in New York in 1907 with his mother and sister, joining his father who was already there. At the age of 14, he enrolled in the School of the Art Institute of Chicago and a year later returned to Poland and enrolled in Krakow's Academy of Fine Arts. In 1913, he returned to Chicago and joined the art scene there, and over the next few years had several exhibitions at local galleries and institutes. In 1922, he married Helen Walker, the artist's daughter of Dr. Samuel J. Walker, a prominent member of Chicago society, which improved his economic standing. They had a daughter, but they were to divorce later in 1932, putting him back where he started, living hand to mouth. He would later marry Joan Lee Donovan in 1934, who had been his daughter's kindergarten teacher. In 1929, he was a founder of an artist movement called Tribe of the Horned Heart. It was centered on Polish artists who sought inspiration in the pagan or pre-Christian history of Poland. During the 1930s, his reputation escalated in his native Poland, and he returned there with Joan to work. This was brought to a halt by the Nazi invasion of Poland in 1939, during which he lost all of his work thus far, as he had taken them with him from America, encouraged by the prospect of building a museum devoted to his art. He was also hurt during the bombing. Influenced by what was going on in Europe at the time, Szukalski developed the pseudo-scientific historical theory of Zermattism, which promoted the concept that all human culture was derived from post-deluge Easter Island and that humankind was locked in an eternal struggle with the sons of Yeti, who he believed to be the offspring of Yeti and humans. For those that don't know, a Yeti is Bigfoot. He spent many, many years writing 42 volumes of manuscripts, totaling more than 25,000 pages on this very subject. These manuscripts included 14,000 illustrations. In 1940, after escaping Poland, he and his wife settled in Los Angeles. Szukalski did odd jobs in film studios, such as designing scenery. There he became friends with the family of George DiCaprio. Following the death of his second wife, Joan, in 1980, he was watched over by the group of friends that he had made in Hollywood. In fact, it was they who spread his ashes on Easter Island in the rock quarry of Rano Rarugu. Bray and his wife, Lena, maintained Szukalski's estate and the great bulk of his existing art under the name Archives Szukalski. Leonardo DiCaprio sponsored a retrospective exhibition of his work entitled Struggle at the Lugana Art Museum in 2000. Szukalski's works are on permanent display at the Polish Museum of America in Chicago. It should be noted that during the research for this film, the makers discovered truths about his activities during the Second World War that caused them much distress. It seems that his time spent in Poland just before the outbreak of war in the late 1930s was not as innocent as he would have preferred others to believe later in life. These tendencies evident in his work are why in contemporary Poland his art has been embraced by the far right. Look out for this documentary, which will be released on Netflix as of December 21st, 2018. I'm your host, Shay Trinity, and as always, this has been an MFR production. Follow us on YouTube, Instagram, and Twitter, and subscribe to this podcast via your favorite podcast reader.